finished, I accept to hand him over to Florida Gardens.
Sincere thanks to the chairman, to the principal and faculty, and all the organizers of Mahoshava Sadhi for giving me an opportunity to share my clinical knowledge and experience with you. Basically, I am from Government Siddha Medical College, Kannanagadi, Tamil Nadu, where I did my both UG and PG. Now I am a faculty of Gunapada, that is Media America. And other part of my routine is I have specialized in medtech innovations, medical technology innovations. And among 10 plus of my innovations, some 3 to 4 innovations are top listed at the national and international levels. So I have designed my presentation into 2 parts. One is the traditional or the Shastric preparations which we use for cancer treatment. Of course, we are having an OPD in our college. We just have completed 50 years, our college has completed 50 years. And we are having a cancer OP for more than 20-25 years. So when I was a UG student, there was cancer OP, and still today we are seeing cancer patients, of course, with much response, positive response. So my topic today is areas of research interest in Siddha oncology. The interest will lead you to many spheres. For example, I heard from the principal and Dr. Ravi Shankar that actually PG students are particularly invited to this thing. And whether you are a PG student or whether you are a faculty, if at all you have some protocols, that is, protocols in the type, prototypes, some working prototypes, there are lots and lots of chances before you that will make you or that will take you to a place which we will never imagine at the instance. I have many such experiences. Apart from cancer, I have developed a transdermal patch, the patch which, when applied to the forehead, reduces fever in 10 to 15 minutes. And of course, it was selected, orchestrated by CAMTEC, that is Consortium for Affordable Health Technologies, belongs to the Massachusetts General Hospital, US. They orchestrated there. They are concentrating in 3 countries, US, Uganda, and India. And in India, they frequently call for such things. They recently conducted a hackathon for cancer. So like that, they are looking for some innovative technologies that is meant for BOP, that is base of pyramid. If at all you claim your innovation or a product or a formulation is more affordable, is aimed towards providing health solutions for the base of pyramid people, then you can do wonders. I just presented my thing, that is the transdermal patch for reducing fever, and at the end of the presentation I was given a very big offer. They said, see, you are having a working prototype, working model, you just transfer out the technology to us and you give us a provisional patency, not a final patency, provisional patency, we will give you 1.5 crores. That was the offer that was given to me. And of course, at that time, when I was something new to that field, it was a great offer. But of course, that did not work out, because apart from commercial things, there are quite a lot of things according to my principle. So far I have not done, or I have not sold our property, that is Ayush medicines, to somebody else who is commercial or who is from the corporate type of thing. So here, let's start it. Of course, the advantage of being in the last session, or speaker in the last session, is that all the vital things, the basics, the principles, the advances, of course everything will be there. You have heard right from the morning itself. So it makes me easy to just tell whatever I have to share with you. So, we are often referred to as Supreme Court. Supreme Court. Because people usually go to all other things that they think of coming to us also, to Ayush people also. Let's give a try to this thing also. In that way, we are often referred to as Supreme Court, the Apex Court. So, what is our success? The most common reasons for using Ayush medicines as per the patient's perspective. See, there are many perspectives. There are the physician's perspective. But we often forget that the patient himself will have his own perspective. And of course, I tell you that we are the people who can satisfy the patient's perspective, because our things or our medicines are more profitable. That comes under the first priority of the patient. Then it closely corresponds to the patient's ideology. It is not complicated, something like that. And of course, it always allies about the adverse effects of chemical and synthetic medicines. And of course, more personalized healthcare can be done. They are assured of more personalized healthcare. And of course, it allows greater public access to health information. Our terminologies are not complicated. Even we can put it in simple words so that they can understand. So, always they are having great public access to health information. And of course, according to me, our medicines is for health promotion and therapy of chronic diseases such as cancer. Then straight away we are going to cancer into siddha. The concept or the entirety of cancer is in no way new to siddha system. It has been well documented throughout our literatures and of course classic tests. It is often referred to as putri in siddha medicine, that is an anthill. The other synonyms are one megam means hypertrophy in state. One megam, hypertrophy. And of course, Grandhi of course you may be familiar with, that is tumors. And apart from herbal mineral formulations, specific herbal minerals and herbal mineral medicines play a very important role in siddha material medical. The symptoms I already told, the foot, snake pit or anthill, one megam, it is not 100% equivalent, it may represent that thing. Hypertrophy or proliferation, then colorite stands for tumors. And of course, Grandhi, swellings where according to our Nadi principle, Vayu and Kapha are involved. Then Maravaikati, Nachu Maravaikati are malignant tumors. Vedi Sulai, again based on Nadi texts, it is Vada with Kapha. Then Vipurudi, again malignant tumors. In National Institute of Siddharth at Tambaram Sanatorium, they use this word only. Vipurudi and one megam for hypertrophy state. Then the distinct advantages of our Ayush systems and particularly in Siddha, distinct advantages lies in the unique diagnostics and therapeutics. There is no doubt about it. Then the oil spreading pattern we are having in Aikuri, of course, up to my knowledge it is available in Ayurveda also, because I had some discussion regarding this. Then wrist circumference, this is somewhat new. My students have put it in the poster. We call it as manikadai, that is wrist circumference, we measure it. Then of course with the fingers, we come to a conclusion. It is graded from 5 to 10. From 5 to 10, there are specific diseases grading. And of course 11 shows no disease, physiologically normal. That is something. And of course exclusive herbal and herbomineral medicines. In the morning, we saw the latest developments regarding the diagnostics and recent advances in the field of oncology. In my experience, however high tech you would be, or however scientific we are, there will be a point when we have to revert back to to revert back for the whole principle. And of course I also thought that this may be hypothetical or this may be theoretical. And the reliability in our diagnostics may be a question mark. Until I
need
to
consider.
He is no more. He was Dr. C and D. They called him as C and D. C and Devanayaka. He is a local modern doctor having a first
CP.
And he is the man behind the siddha band therapy for HIV AIDS in Thambaram Sanatorium in Chennai. I met him and he told me, what about the nakuli? Do you use it in your hospital, in your clinical practice? Then I said, of course, in my opinion, that is a little bit theoretical, sir, or even hypothetical. Then he said, see, I am an allopath. I never use ELISA and Western blot to confirm the diagnosis of HIV. Instead, I do this nakuli. So it was taken aback. It was just amazing. When we hear about the speciality of our own system or our own therapeutics from other person in the sense not directly related to our field, then only we understand or we realize what actually is there. So, I used to tell my students, see, we are not going to discover anything new. It is only going to be the rediscoveries of what is already found, what is already there in our literatures. Perhaps in modern terminology. That is my finding and my perception regarding the diagnostics and our basis. Then, regarding the evidence-based interventions, there are references in classic Siddha texts. Then we have time-tested, they are the medicines are time-tested with proven efficacy and safety profile. Then improves quality of life. As our previous speaker said, improving the quality of life is a very positive finding in the management of cancer. That is very important, again, in the patient's perspective. Then, non-invasive and standalone medicines. In my experience, when you say our method is a non-invasive method, then of course, you will be in a hierarchy. Then standalone medicines, regarding cancer, we cannot give such a 100% claim, but if at all our medicine is a standalone medicine, priority will be nationally and internationally. Then, regarding cost effective and the medicine should be patient friendly. Patient friendly in the sense, prolong the hospitalization, if at all our medicine avoids prolonged hospitalization. Then it is certainly a patient friendly medicine. Then well documented preclinical and the clinical data, all these things we can have as evidence-based interventions. Then evidence-based health of mineral traditional preparations that we use in our Siddha medicine. Of course, they are having heavy metals, they are having mercurials, they are having arsenicals. We don't have any doubts in claiming that we are using mercurials, arsenicals, but according to the principle, risk versus benefit, we are using it. Of course, we are using it legitimately. With the legal thing. Kamiragatta Chandura. In the morning I heard from a doctor, from an Ayurveda doctor at Manipal University, that he himself uses in Kamiragatta Chandura. And of course, upon his prescription, the medical shops here have stored Kamiragatta Chandura. So I have listed it in the top number one. Kamiragatta Chandura has definite anti-cancer property. It is a very sustained medicine. Then iron chanduram, that is iron we are having. Then RGM stands for Rasagandhi Melaki, which is having 48 ingredients including mercury and sulfur. RGM is a very, very useful medicine, particularly in treating rare diseases. Then we have the Chattamata chanduram, we call it as Pachayvettu Marandu, which never goes to fire or anything. Just grind it and then use it. And of course, Neeradi Muthu Valladi, Hydrocarbons Vaithyana, that medicine contains. Then Padya Pashana Chandu, arsenicals, it contains mercurials and arsenicals. Then Kayamatra is a herbal formulation which we use in our OPD, in our cancer OPD. Then Chitra Moola Kuligate, Lumbago Xylanica, you know, the combination, along with Kalam, mercury.
electric chloride. Then Gauri Sintamani Sanduram, in the dose of 65 to 130 milligrams. These are the common medicines which are being used in our siddha system to treat cancer. Then again, as I top-listed it, I have given Tamiragatti Chanduram. It contains copper, chembu. Reference is from palm leaf manuscripts. Palm leaf manuscripts. And the ingredients are copper, arsenic trisulfate, mercury, sulfur, sodium chloride, potassium nitrate. And this is being processed in 4 peripheral juices. That is made perfection, or even you people call it as siddhi, making siddhi. Actually, 10 days back, I presented a paper in RAPCS 2017, that is recent research advances in chemical sciences, pharmaceutical and chemical sciences at New Delhi, in which we presented this form of scientific validation of making siddhi, making perfection with herbal juices. So we took Rambu Kappam cloves, we prepared it according to our texture, we processed it with 4 juices, and we took the reference from the USDA, United States Department of Agriculture. Ascorbic acid standard, they have fixed it at 2 microgram to 4 microgram in any sample of clove. But after the process, it increased multifold. It was around 600 to 800 micrograms of ascorbic acid in a single sample. So what brings the change? So processing with herbal juices brings wonders. Brings wonders, there is no doubt about it. Of course, we cannot boast in everything. It's well defined. What we are just trying to do is giving some interpretation in the modern terms. And of course, it is indicated for cancer, specific cancers of cheek, breast, tongue, uterus and lung. And of course, the dose is 25 milligrams twice daily with kaniyapattu. This is Tamiragatti Chanduram. It is commercially available. Some pharmas in our Tamil Nadu, namely SKM Pharma, they are preparing it. Then Chitramula Kuligai, Splumbago Xylanica, with Puram Calomel, Hydrogenum, Subchloride, then Omum, Carum Copticum, and the Palm Jacket, Borassus Flapillifer. Indications are carcinoma of male and female genitals and cancerous ulcers. So, all through the way, you can note a thing that the indications are specific, type specific. That is, okay, another specialty. Then this is the census taken from our cancer OPD. Of course, I have given only 3 year census and the total cases run up to 120 plus 7. It has been running for years together. And of course, we are having solid attendance of cancer patients, and we are doing something good. As you know, as is the situation in a government college, follow-up is something rare. And of course, I don't want to mention it because being a government, I am being in the government service. We are having our own limitations, so I don't take this number as a tall claim or anything. Yes. The medicines used in our OPD is Chitramula Kuligai and Kayama. Chitramula Kuligai, Lambaga Zellanika, I already told. Then Rasakanthi Melagu, RGM. Then Nellikai Lege, Mamla. Same is the treatment regime for HIV also. For example, we call it as RAN therapy, R for Rasakanthi Melagu. A for Ashwagandhi Churanam, that is Ashwagandha, you know. And N for Nellikai. Nellikai Lege, Mamla. Of course, it is very effective. RAN therapy is effective in HIV. Okay, with this, we end the Shastric or the traditional part. Then we are into the next, the second part. That is objective of research in Ayush. So what may be the objectives of research? To ensure safety and efficacy of our drugs. And again, to exchange the information. To document it, to achieve the goal of global acceptance. That is very, very important. See, we are having wonderful medicines. We are having wonderful feedback and follow-up of patients. Then what about the next stage? We have to go to the next stage. Next stage is nothing but acceptance of our medicines at the global level. revalidation of the claims and safety of drugs. There are many claims. We have to revalidate. We have to document them again in the scientific terms which the modern world accepts. That is essentially a part of the objective of research in our audio systems. Then comes improving the quality and value of research. That is a vital thing. And of course, summary is key issues for developing methodologies for research and evaluation of Ayush drugs. See, what happens in experimental pharmacology is, if at all we are going to evaluate a drug for its anti-inflammatory activity, for acute anti-inflammatory, we have to go for inquiry. And for chronic, we have to go for cotton pellet granuloma methods. But these methods, according to my opinion, have their own limitations. So, I can call it as a dream. We should have our own evaluative methods for operation so that we can bring every possible principles into the protocols. That is, of course, to be worked out. Then to popularize the utilization of our drugs. Then again, I have sorted out some new techniques for old treatments. People simply called us giving old treatments. They can evaluate them. How is that? The techniques and processes are reverse pharmacology. You will be familiar with the term. That is, you are given the sample. You go back first to find out whatever is found in the sample. That is, start with the end product and work backwards to find out what it contains and how it functions. So, reverse pharmacology, we have done a lot. We are continuously doing it. Then the second method is high thorough screening. That is data processing. You all know about dry lab, wet lab, something like that. We are having softwares. Of course, having their own limitations. But we can use data processing. We call it as high throughput screening. Then ethnopharmacology, everyone knows the study of the medicines belonging to particular ethnic groups. We have some very wonderful ethnopharmacological medicines. And the last one is systems biology. You all know the inventor of email. Who is the inventor of email? There may be some controversies, but the inventor of email is
Shiva Yad,
right, from our own country. He is the ambassador of systems biology. He always advocates siddha drugs and Ayush drugs for people. And he has developed his own systems biology. He is very confident about the positiveness of this thing. So, it is the science of understanding the different way chemical and metabolic processes interact with the body. These are some new techniques to evaluate our medicines. Then potential areas of research interest, of course, reviewing, updating the document, clarify our basic principles, our interaction with the allied fields. Then of course, medical instrumentation is applied to Ayush oncology, with special reference to oncology. We should have medical instruments. See, if at all I say for diagnosis, for diagnostics, or even for preventive and prophylactic purpose, we can use the manikadai node, wrist circumference. Then we should find out ways to make it as an instrument, as a working protocol. Again, it continues. Technology-based solutions to anti-cancer preparations and delivery systems. The New Year guidelines, this as you already told. And of course, medtech innovations leading to IPR, intellectual property rights. Then types of operations we all know. From say the classic test, of any medicine, any system of medicine, the new drug entities. Then comes the priority in drug formulation for greater diseases. I have already given a small intro regarding this. First thing, the first priority is cost effectiveness. So how much will a treatment regime cost for a patient? Patient always takes into consideration this thing first. Efficacy comes next. Cost effectiveness is the first and foremost thing. Then of course, side effects. They are very much aware about the effect, side effects. So we should find our ways to lessen the side effects. Then less invasive. It should be less invasive. It should be easily available, not habit forming.
And of course, if at all you use the new drug delivery system, that is what I told about the patch, transdermal patch. See, if at all you use the new drug delivery system, you have a wider open for acceptability for everything. So new drug delivery system incorporating ways of finding out new drug delivery system is essential. Then strategies, of course, we all know about the new molecular entities and the reverse pharmacological approach. Then ICMR, in the morning, our speaker told, Indian Council for Medical Research, it has certain guidelines. We can make use of those guidelines. See, what ICMR says is, if at all you select a medicine, you prepare a medicine, which is found in your text, and you are using it for the same indication as mentioned in the text, then there is no need to go for phase 1 and phase 2 of the 4-phase clinical trials. See, you all know drug development is a very long process. It takes nearly 10 years and millions of rupees or dollars for a drug to enter into the market. And that is because of the protocol or satisfying the clinical phases. But actually, ICMR gives us this sort of concerns, special concerns. We can skip phase 1 and phase 2, which means we can bring out our drugs positively in a very short period. This is regarding Ayush medicines used by all the Ayush physicians, then physicians from other field, then new chemical entities, and of course an extract or a compound isolated from a plant which has never been in use. It should be considered as a new drug. Then coming to this thing, this is a fortified papilly. This is a herbal formulation for oral cancer. This was selected among top 50 innovations of India Innovation Growth Program. In 2014, actually IITP is the initiative of BST, Department of Science and Technology, and Lockheed Martin. You may heard about Lockheed Martin. They are the developers and suppliers of F-16 fighter planes. So basically, what may be the role of a firm or a concern that produces fighter plane to enter into the drug industry or enter into the innovation industry? They may claim, see, our innovation is F-16 fighter planes. We are in lookout of similar innovations. So they, along with FICCI, Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industries, and DST, Department of Science and Technology, they are periodically conducting, year by year. Actually, there was a call for 2017 also, for top innovations in India. And of course, this particular herbal formulation for oral cancer was selected among the top 50, and I presented it in the Federation of New Delhi, in front of an international jury. And at the end of the presentation, it was heavily appreciated. But one particular person who was in the first row, who is a CSIR person, he told the VP, the Vice President of Lockheed Martin, who was from the US, this is a nice drug, no doubt about it. Then he asked me the first question, are you an Ayurveda doctor? Because they are not aware of the term siddha. No sir, I am a siddha doctor, I am from Tirunelveli, I am in a teaching faculty. Then he said, what about the reference? I said, the reference is from the classical text, sir. Age-old classical text. Then he left me, he turned over to the jury and told, this is a nice medicine, but we can never get patency for this. Because I am from CSIR, it comes under PKDL. So, in no way, this can be commercially marketed. So that particular incident led me to modify all the further innovations. So my latest innovation for cervical cancer, a formulation, it has been modified. It is not in the original form. Because of the experience I had at Federation House, New Delhi. Then this is regarding the development status in Shiga cell line. Kila cell line, Shiga cell line,
we are having in vitro studies, quite a lot of in vitro studies. They are not 100% evidence, but they are supporting evidence and supporting documents that the drug possesses certain activity.
So, I am not sure if you can see the terms, cell shrinkage, then membrane blubbing and apoptosis. These are all very encouraging terms in any drug discovery concerned with the cancer. These are very positive findings. And of course, the oral cancer drug, it exhibited 85% cancer activity, even at a minimum concentration. It was a terrible drug. I am not mentioning the name. Why? Because I have entered into a NDA, non-disclosure agreement. And of course, I have further entered into a PE, business engagement agreement, with Sahul India, a multinational company from West Bengal. So I am not in a position to disclose whatever the ingredients are. But I can tell you, I have noted it at takeaway points. It contains dye, a dyeing principle. So in my experience, and whatever I collected from my traditional practitioners, siddha traditional practitioners, dye containing plants have anti-cancer properties. This is for sure. And of course, my formulations have either dye or calomel in the metal mineral thing, which I have given us takeaway points. Then development status, report and treatment with a drug. This is one of the case I treated for oral cancer. Then of course, in this slide, there is an ethical issue. I told the patient that I am going to take a photograph of you before and after treatment. And no need to worry, I will not disclose your name. I will simply mask your eyes so that your identity cannot be revealed. She simply said, no doctor, don't just do it. Just take me and publish me, my face. Let those who see understand that I am a living example of the greatness of Siddha and Siddha medicine, anti-cancer medicine. So I have left it like this. The first one is before treatment and the other one is after treatment. Treated with the herbal medicine which I presented at the unit. Then integrative oncotherapy, another important area is integrative oncotherapy. This paper was presented at Manipal University. Of course, the students, my students who presented the paper, some of them have come here. They are here. They presented posters today. So, this is from our experience, clinical experience. We have two drugs, modified drugs, and we gave the drugs to patients on chemotherapy and radiation. So what the net result or what the observation we found and the patient themselves found is the side effects were reduced. See, whenever we prepare a patient for radiation or chemotherapy, they will be aware, the first thing that strikes them is that hair loss, then pigmentation of the face, etc. Our herbal medicine given to cancer patients on chemotherapy and radiation reduced the side effects. Hair loss was not there, it was reduced, hair loss was greatly reduced. There was lesser pigmentation. And of course, apart from reducing the side effects of radiation and chemotherapy, the formulation itself exhibited 62.59 anti-cancer activity. So it has dual actions. And of course, it is best advised for both prophylactic and therapeutic actions. Then evidence to reverse pharmacology, we submitted it in yet another conference. Two Siddha medicines, B7 for breast cancer and KKPN for cervical cancer, they were selected. And it was studied through reverse pharmacology, they were end medicines. And IC50 value for B07 is 1.429 microgram per ml. And the LD50 for cervical cancer medicine is 173.99 microgram per ml. So these are all some positive findings to indicate us that we can work further on these preparations or formulations. Then again, this is regarding polyvalent formation for breast cancer, which I told in the previous slide, A07. And again, we focused on A549 lung carcinoma cells also. This paper was published in the Asian Journal of Pharmaceutical and Clinical Research just in this year itself, February 2017. So this shows the concentration and the inhibition, anti-cancer viability percentage. So LD50 value, we have mentioned it. This again is a positive finding that we are going in the correct direction. Again, maximum inhibition is achieved at the higher concentration of 100 microgram. Least concentration is 6.25 microgram, where half of the proliferating cell would be destroyed in very lower concentration. And this drug inhibits the cell proliferation even at its lower concentration and gradually increasing at higher levels. Then takeaways. These are some takeaways I am going to give you today. In our observation and research, I have already told you the first point. The thing or the information we collected from our traditional practitioners and from our own experience in preclinical cancer screening, dye-containing plants have anti-cancer properties. And of course, in most of the siddha anti-cancer preparations, the usage of boma, carob coptic, ajwan. So, in herbal sector and calomel, that is rasa kapura, in the mineral sector, mercurous chloride have been observed. Then kaya kalpa medicines are equally effective in prophylaxis and therapeutics. I stress here, kaya kalpa and antioxidants do have a direct and certain role in anti-cancer formulations. I said during integrative oncology, two drugs, and one drug is a known and proven antioxidant, kaya kalpa. The other one is a directed drug for cancer. And of course the probable mode of action may be our anti-cancer formation significantly decreases the level of marker enzymes and lipid peroxides and increases the level of antioxidant enzymes. That is why I stressed much on antioxidants. Then regarding adverse effect, of course it was no significant. And of course, by means of their antioxidant and free radical quenching effects, they have definite anti-cancer effect. This is somewhat rough for a broad mode of action, according to us. Then facing the challenges, of course, we are having quite a lot of challenges before us. To face it well, to face it effectively, we have to revise our ancient methods, apply latest techniques without changing the basic concepts, then improve the quality control and quality assurance, explain our Ayush system in modern scientific language, and of course we should employ wider clinical applications for positive health, and finally, modernization is the prioritized answer for globalization. Globalization, of course, is very, very important to have a wider dissemination of our medicines and of our people. So, I have an open call, as I told in the first phase of my speech. Do you have a great and promising concept? Need not essentially be a concept, because a concept may be hypothetical. Do you have a prototype? It may be an early prototype or a late prototype. The early prototype confines itself to the lab itself. Late prototype, of course, fully functional lab prototype with some clinical evidence. Do you have such things? Then, of course, the sky will be your limit. If at all you present your concept or the prototype in the proper format to the proper people, wonders can be done. As I said, IIGP is periodically and annually calling for new innovations. They will select the 50 innovations and they will give you product commercialization training at the IIT New Delhi. Then there is CIA, Confederation of Indian Industries. They also call for innovations, medical innovations. Of course, the fever cluster was initially selected by CIA. And I presented it at IIT New Delhi, where it was much appreciated. Then only CanTech came to know about it, and they asked me to present it before them in Bangalore. I presented it in Bangalore and I was offered that great honor. So, do you have such a thing? Since you are BDs, since you are faculties, there will be quite a lot of things. To put it in the new way, or to introduce or manifest it as a new drug delivery system. If you have such things or concepts or working prototypes or instruments or new drug delivery systems, of course, they are having quite a lot of opportunities. Then do you have clinically proven formulations for cancer treatment? Do you possess working prototypes? Can you design a new drug delivery system? If so, the future is certainly ours. And of course, I can give you the way to submit proposals or suggest ways. You can contact me through your institution, through your faculty members. That's all I have today. Fine. Thank you.